I flip the pages of my life. Every line that I write as I make history. You could see me. You could see me. You could see me. Yeah. 'Cause my life is an open book. Oh, my life is an open book. Oh, my life is an open book. As I make history. You could see me. Yeah.
So sure when. You know, the lady prophesied that God is going to take you to the nations. When did you start traveling and going to the people with the gospel?
Well, I mean, outside of Tobago, which we
Tobago is Trinidad, yeah. Show it.
You know, some people, when you tell them, have you ever left Trinidad? They say, yeah, I went to Tobago, you know. But outside of that, the first place I went to was Antigua with Pastor Terry Bates. Mm-hmm. That's a few years well. And funny enough, I'm actually in Antigua at St. John's Pentecostal Church as one of the music ministers and media director of the church right now. And from there, God has taken me from there to a lot of the major territories of the world. And currently the new album is called 25. But I work really hard on it because I'm exposed to a lot of the Spanish community.
Right, and you were nominated for Foreign Language.
Foreign Language in the Marlon Awards this year as well.
Congratulations.
So thank you,
on
thank
your
you.
Multiple nominations.
Yes, I think me and Positive from Trinidad.
14 or something.
Yeah, we have the most nominations this year.
Yeah.
You know, so yeah, so I pushed myself a little bit hard and I actually have two full Spanish songs on this album, thanks to Ruth Vega from the United States. She's also born in Puerto Rico, so she kind of coached me on them. And slowly now having to start to learn to speak it, so I had to go Rosetta Stone and
right.
lessons and all these different things like
that.
Not that easy. Let's keep it. Let's keep it like this. Let's keep it in English today. You know what I mean? But God is really, really opening up some more doors. This year we'll be going to Africa. Mm-hmm. We're also going to Europe and England. We're doing an English tour. And we have some interest in even up to places like Australia.
Oh,
so Australia is one of the few continents that I haven't
you
been
need
to
see. Someone to carry your suitcase. I will carry your suitcase very humbly,
yeah,
you know.
So. I ain't reached that level yet where I want my suitcase carried, yeah. You know, maybe next time, you know.
Right.
But yeah, so I really bless God for what he's doing. In terms of with my ministry and stuff like that, and you know, just trying to keep focus and trying to really take not just the gospel but even Trinidad and Tobago,
yeah.
And our culture and our music to the world.
Sure, we can go all over, but
right.
Number one on iTunes.
Yes, bless God. I really, really.
Sure,
I mean, when I first heard it, I was really shocked. One of my friends called me and he looked at it and then I was like, yo, dude, you're joking. You know what I mean? And then I went and I checked it myself and saw it.
You know. Gospel music out of Trinidad and Tobago, eh? Gospel music representing Christ.
And funny thing is, you know, there's a lot of, I think Bungie did it last year, sometime last
With
year.
That same song.
Different theology. And, I think some other artists from Trinidad did it before. But this is the first time somebody in the gospel industry has ever reached to number one, even within the region, you know, because
right.
after I was number one, then Beyonce was number two and Jay-Z was number three and some other albums was number four and five and Marshall was number seven.
So it was really an amazing thing for
day for gospel music. The thing is, and I would say this to all the young people and all the young artists, there's a lot of hard work for it. Because
yeah.
in this album, you know, I did a lot of Instagram, a lot of people come inside of the album because I have a lot of fans from all over the world. So by doing that, people felt connected to the album.
Yeah. Yeah.
So they were waiting and looking forward for certain songs and stuff like that. So, you know, people from all over the world were buying the CDs. So when I saw that, I really say, you know, sometimes the hard work paid off. You know, I wasn't lazy on the album. I didn't just do everything in Antigua.
Yeah.
I went to England and finished it because I'm comfortable in the studio that I work with in England. And
yeah.
sometimes just being away from a certain environment helps you, you know. And I must say kudos not only to that but to my pastor and having good leadership, because you see a lot of people sing and write but they're not under good leaders,
right.
And some of them don't even submit to the pastors,
right.
And having a good covering somebody you could ask questions, because a lot of times even some of these songs God gave me the inspiration but I needed just direction into where to take this,
you
and
know,
I would sit with my pastor and talk to him about some of these songs, you know what I mean? So but most of the inspiration really just comes from the Holy Spirit and sitting in church. and hearing. Sometimes you hear something, you hear the word, and you're like, yo, hey, this is a song. You know what I mean? I
just I'm God's design. Yeah. So you sing it for me now. Let me go in my
God's Design is the oldest song on the album, you know.
God's Design was birthed in my spirit in 2012, the ending of 2012.
Showing. If I want to pray, you know, sometimes it doesn't be in a place where you could really submit yourself.
Right.
And I just listen to this song. Yeah, you know, at that point, I don't remember Showing is my friend. I just reached in that place. Please. Because that song is really, really anointed.
Definitely. I remember clearly I was in something called 12-12-12 in Antigua. And the whole concept came into my spirit, and I didn't write it. I came back to Trinidad. I was in Trinidad for some time, and I keep hearing the melody, which was that part. I'm God's design. And I keep there and I saying, Lord, how to do this? You know, which way? Is it fast? Is it slow?
Yeah.
And then one day I just pushed myself. I called Casio, my cousin,
yeah,
and we sat down together. And that's how the whole song actually came in fruition, and that's actually one of the most popular songs to date on the album in most of the islands and countries.
Imagine.
You know what I mean? So it is really, really a blessing. I think the only other song that really is in that category in terms of blessing the masses is another worship song called Forever God. And that is doing really well as well. And that's one of the songs that really is blessing.
Hey, look what I have! And yep. I want Showen to sign my autograph for me. I mean, my CD. Autograph my CD. That. I get so excited. I started to talk all kind of thing. I make sure, because I came to the launch on Easter Monday. And I just mean that, you know, you should sign it for
I still
me.
Have to get a marker, but I'll press it out for you.
I realize.
Yeah, because it's high gloss.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. So, you know, what song's gonna, you know, I mean, it's a great album. You know, yeah, people just have their favorite. You know how it goes.
I guess when you listen to the entire CD, then you would tell me what is your favorite. I'm sure God's Design might be number two now. when you hear the rest. Because a lot of people who actually love that one the most after listening to the album was like, yo, whoa, the worship.
Go on iTunes and get it!
Definitely.
Anyway, we have to wrap up. But you know, I will cheat a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Because I really want you to play this game. So what you have to do is guess where I'm taking you. Guess where we're going.
No problem.
Right? But it's a conversation, so you have to talk to me.
No problem.
So, you know, we wake up early in the morning and we decide that we're going to have a fun-filled day. I mean, the sun is shining, you know, the food cooking, you know.
Crab and dumpling.
I mean, we can buy crab.
We can buy crab and dumpling.
We can buy crab and dumpling there, you know. But, you know, it's mostly have like popcorn and candy and tight ropes, and you know,
tight ropes.
You only have like a minute to guess.
It's something like somewhere like a fun park.
It is a fun park, you know. You have lots of fun. You see lots of animals.
The zoo?
Oh no, it's a place like the zoo, but you know,
a circus.
We're going to the circus.
He got it. Thank you so much, Showen, for, you know, inviting us into your space, because I know this is wind down time before, you know, Liberation Day, and we have this nice poolside. Thank you so much. God bless you. God bless your ministry.
And before I go, I just want to encourage the young people and the young artists out there to keep pressing. Don't give up. You know what I mean? A lot of times people have talent and they choose the world over the church. And for me, even though it may be look harder, it's supposed to be harder because we're kingdom people and the enemy want to stop us from changing lives and from bringing that good message and that gospel message. So don't care what people think or say, and stop studying if you're getting airplay or you're not getting airplay. Those things is not important. What is important is making sure that you hear from God and write stuff that would really, really bring a blessing or some sort of change to someone's life. And that is what's important. Forget the airplay thing. Everybody focusing. A big song. I don't need a big song. What I need is my God, who is a big God and he will give you everything else that you desire.
Showing people trying to get into contact with you, give us your Twitter, Instagram, Facebook.
Well, everything is Showing Gardener. Right. So showinggardener.com on Twitter is Showing Gardener. If you go to Facebook, just type in Showing Gardener, it's Showing Gardener Ministry. But if you go to showinggardener.com, which is my website, you would get all the information, everything that you need. And iTunes, Amazon, everybody has the music. All you need to do is just type it in. Look for the album with the V in the front, but it's Benti Cinco 25. That is what it is.
Thank you so much.
No problem. Yeah.